Hi, welcome back to my channel. Yes, it's Adeze. I know I look different, okay? Some of you are wondering, is that not Rihanna? Did Rihanna add it? Is she now pregnant? No, it's not Rihanna, okay? This is Adeze here. I decided to just do some makeup today and I'm feeling myself. So I asked you guys on my YouTube community to ask me questions concerning finance in the home. You know, how do we manage finance in the home? Who brings what percentage, you know, all kinds of questions. And I got quite a lot of questions, very interesting questions. And I'm so excited to be answering them in today's video, okay? Yeah, so if you'd like to know my answers and if you'd like to know my thoughts generally about finance in the home, then just keep on watching. Okay, so before we start, as usual, you guys know I always give disclaimers in my videos because of Indinachoku. People that are looking for what to say, okay? So I'm going to give disclaimer. No, I'm not even giving any disclaimer, okay? Believe what you want to believe, I beg. I'm not even giving any disclaimer. So the first question is from Chidima and she's asking, do you think it's a good idea for a woman to have a secret account or other things without the knowledge of her husband? Okay. This is an interesting question. I'm going to give you guys the politically correct answer and I'm going to give you guys the street answer, okay? Politically correct answer. Is it politically correct? Okay. Morally correct answer. No, you should not have secrets from your husband. You should not keep anything a secret from your husband. Personally, what happens in my own home, I do not have any secret account that my husband doesn't know about. And he does not, to the best of my knowledge, he does not have any secret account that I do not know about, okay? Now, does he have access to my account? No. Do I have access to his own account? No. But basically, how much we have, how much we earn, how much we, you know, save, how much we invest, how much we do, you know, whatever we do, it is not a secret to the both of us, okay? I tell him everything. I know all his passwords. I have all his account details, passwords, anything he needs to, anything that I need for access to his account, I have them. And anything he needs for access to my account, okay, he doesn't have them, but I'll try and send them to him, okay? But yeah, basically, we don't keep secrets in this home. I personally believe that when you have a good husband, when you have a good spouse, you shouldn't be keeping secrets from them. When you have a financially responsible spouse, what's the point? Like, you shouldn't be keeping secrets for them. They should know for all kinds of reasons, basically. Emergency reasons, for, you know, putting heads together to, you know, plan and to, you know, pray about things. Even for him to advise you or for you to advise him or whatever the case may be. There are so many benefits to letting your spouse know how much you earn, how much you save, you know, all the accounts you have and all that, okay? So that's the morally, politically correct answer. Now, the street answer is, sister, you know who you married, okay? You know the man you married. All this one, I'm just talking. If I had married a man who is financially irresponsible or who is tricking eye in my money, like if I make 10 naira, he's asking me for 5, or he's always like trying to look for ways for me to spend my money in the home or spend my money on him or something. My dear sister, you know who you married, okay? If you marry such a man, I will advise you to please go and look for an account that nobody knows about. No, somebody should know, somebody should know. But don't let him not know every detail of your earnings and your savings and all that, simply because he is not a financially responsible person. Don't say you are there praying for him to change. No, you know who you married, okay? You know, just know your spouse, okay? And then try and work around, you know, issues like that to avoid future complications, okay? Okay, so the next question is from Gusta's channel. Hi, and she's saying, is it okay for a man to share financial responsibilities with his wife, or the woman should assist with money when she feels the need to, or when she feels like she needs to? Personally, what I believe is financial responsibilities in the home belong to the husband. That is my own personal belief, okay? So please don't come for me. That's my own personal belief. I believe that financial responsibilities in the home belong to the man. Now, does it mean that you shouldn't contribute to your home? No, absolutely not. If you are making money, then you have to, you know, contribute, or you should contribute, or you should try to contribute, except it tells you not to contribute, which is actually a plus. Okay, let me just tell you what I believe, basically, and why I believe so. Now, it is a man's responsibility, it is a husband's responsibility to take care financially, to provide for his family. It is his responsibility to provide, okay? But it is not his responsibility to provide all your needs according to his riches and glory in Christ Jesus. Okay? It is not your husband's responsibility to provide every single thing you need in this life. Okay? Every single thing you want in this life, it is not his responsibility to provide it, okay? So, in cases where, you know, there are some things I don't just ask my husband money for, not because I can't ask him or I shouldn't ask him, but I just like, Abel, you, Seth, you are earning some money. You should be able to do some things for yourself without asking him, okay? That is why I do not ask him. But if you have a husband that wants to do everything, I mean, that's all well and good. And then if the wife is working and she's bringing in income, she should also contribute where she deems fit. That's my opinion, Aka. That's my opinion, Aka. So the next question is from Didi. Hi, Didi. And she's asking, is it fair for a man to demand a woman contribute to the finances of the home when he doesn't contribute to the chores in the home? The woman works and still does everything in the home down to a T. Your response will be appreciated. For me, it is not fair. It is very, very unfair. If he does not want to contribute, you know, if he doesn't want to do anything in the home, then he should pay heavily for it. He should compensate for, you know, the work that he doesn't want to do in the home. And yeah, that's why somebody asked me, someone has asked me this question before, and I think that the question is here. If I see it, I'll read it out. Do I believe in 50-50 contribution, you know, in the home, financial contribution in the home? For me, the answer is N to the O, okay? No, I do not believe in 50-50 contributions to the home, simply because you cannot contribute 50-50 with your husband. You cannot. It is not physically possible for him to contribute 50-50 in the home. You know why? He does not have a uterus. He does not have a womb. He does not have breast to breastfeed a baby. He's not the one that hears mommy, mommy every time. You know, except you have a husband who is very, very, even at that, like, as, see, childbirth trumps any other thing you want to say. Okay, childbirth trumps any other thing you want to say. Yes, you have a husband who is dedicated, who is very helpful, who is very domesticated. Like, my husband is someone that helps around the house very well, okay? Carries baby very well, takes care of my kids very well. As much as he is a very hands-on, like real hands-on dad, he still cannot beat me at my own game. Because does he have stretch marks from pregnancy? No, he does not. Does he have saggy boobs from pregnancy? No, he does not. Does he have hormonal changes and hormonal issues and everything that comes with pregnancy and childbirth and, you know, the whole, you know, female experience? No, he does not. So, and we are both bringing these kids into this world for the both of us. So how do you now balance out your own part? How do you balance your own part? It is by providing for the home, okay? Yeah, so that's what I just believe. You cannot contribute 50-50 to the home. It does not work, okay? What I believe in is contributing 100%. Both of you contribute 100-100, okay? Now, what does that mean? As a woman, as to the best of my ability, what I can do in my home, I am going to do it 100%, okay? And as a man, to the best of his ability, what he can do in the home, he is going to do it 100%. Because if you think about it, if in addition to childbirth and, you know, child caring or caring for your child, you are adding house chores and you are also adding financial responsibility, it is not balanced. So his own work is just to wake up in the morning, eat, go out, make money and come back. Then me, I wake up in the morning, I'll eat, I'll go out, I'll make money, I'll come back, I'll take care of my children, I'll do this, I'll do that. No, then it's not balanced, okay? Okay, next one is from Daphne, and she's asking, Adeze, apart from bulk shopping for home items, how else do you reduce unnecessary expenses and develop a saving culture as a woman? See, we all have this struggle, okay? We all, like, I don't want to come here now. In theory, I know what to say to you in theory. Like, I know how to break it down for you, how you can save as a woman. I know how to do it in theory. But how practical is it? How me that I'm coming here to preach, do I practice what I preach? That's the question that we need to answer together, okay? Yeah, it's actually very difficult as a woman to save, especially when you now start having kids. Like, I used to save more when I didn't have kids than when after I started having kids, okay? So it's quite difficult, but the truth is, if you make up your mind that you are going to save, because, yeah, even though I'm talking, actually, this year, I actually tried, man. Like, yeah, I started the year badly, but by the end of the year, I actually tried. I even met my target that I, you know, had in mind that I was going to save, okay? So, yeah, it's something that as a woman, you have to just be very, very conscious of. Aside bulk buying, sometimes bulk buying doesn't even work for me. That's the truth. Sometimes it doesn't work for me. But aside bulk buying, you can also, you know, reduce things that you actually buy. Do you understand? For instance, you are always buying things like, let's say you're always buying, what can I use as an example? Let's say an expensive milk. Even though you buy it in bulk, it is still an expensive milk. So you can buy a cheaper milk, okay? Still does the same thing. It might not taste the same. Okay, I'm a pig girl, so it might not taste the same. But, you know, you're buying a cheaper milk in bulk. Okay, so do you understand? So cut out some things entirely from your list, okay? Cut them out entirely. And some things that, yes, even though you're bulk buying, you get them cheaper, they are still more expensive than, you know, other products in the market. So just try and get cheaper ones, okay? Another thing you can do is thrifts, okay? Thrift shopping, like you want to buy clothes, you want to buy shoes, you can go thrift shopping. You can even reduce the amount of clothes and shoes that you buy, okay? So, yeah, basically, these are the ways that I actually save money. But like I said, it's easier said than done. So let me not even come and be a hypocrite and come here and start talking like that's how I used to save money anyhow. Even me, I do a lot of nonsense spending. And when I look back, I'm just like, why? Why did I buy this thing now? Why? Yeah. All right, so the next one is from Janet, okay? And she's asking, is this fair for a woman to take up all responsibilities at home? No, it's not fair. It doesn't even make sense. Why are you now married? Why are you now married? Are you one of those women in the Bible that it says at the end, in the end times, some women will go and meet one man and say, don't take care of us, don't spend on us, don't do anything for us, let's just take your last name and have children for you? Are you one of those women? Are you one of them? If you're not one of them, then it doesn't make sense for a woman to take up all responsibilities in the home. Like, so why are you now married, okay? So this next one is not a question, but it's a comment from Ngozi Ariel. And she's saying, don't marry for money, but pray that your perfectly aligned spouse has money. That is, perfectly aligned is emotionally and spiritually. And I'm like, yes, girl, that's what I always say, my dear. I always say, don't marry for money, but go to where rich people are and marry for love. I'm telling you, sister. See, let me tell you something there. I've noticed one thing about black women in general. I'm not talking about just Nigeria. Nigeria, we're even trying. Black women, especially in black America and, you know, black women in general. Why are we always the poster children, the cover girls, the poster, you know, the epitome of struggle? Why are we always the face of struggle in the world? Why are we always the ones who wants to be the ride or die? We're the ones who want to be the hardworking, strong woman, strong black woman. You know, why are we the ones that kite on our head like that? Because if you go to other cultures and in Africa too, in Nigeria, many women are taught how to be taken care of. They are taught that the men are supposed to take care of them. They are taught these things right from when they are small. And many men are raised to know that it is their responsibility, especially financially, to take care of their women. So you don't see white women walking up and down saying things like, you know, I don't need a man to spend on me. I don't need a man to take care of me. I got my own coins. Nobody's saying you should not get your own coins. Please, that's not what we're saying. You should get your own coins, but he should also get his own coins, okay? If possible, he should get more than you. It's better. It's better that way. It is better that way. Men are naturally providers. They are natural. A good man loves to provide for his home. And I'm telling you facts. Go and talk. I've talked with several men in different capacities, in different places, in different ways. I have even seen many people's comments online. I have taken the pulse, basically, of the population, of the male population. Okay? What do men generally think about providing for the home? You will see that good men, well-raised men, are happy to provide for their wives. Like, it is a joy. That's what gives them joy, okay? Like, one thing my dad told me that stuck with me. My husband is not a very romantic person. Like, he can be, because I'm not even that romantic myself, so maybe I'm even worse than him. But he's not a very, like, overtly sentimental or overtly, you know, sensual, or, you know, he's not very romantic. Let me just put it that way. But he's very hardworking. He's the kind of person that he likes to provide for the home. He likes to clean the home. He likes to, you know, wash clothes, take care of the children, make sure that anything they need is available. He's the one that likes to remember, okay, does Eva have diaper? Does Cora have milk? Does this one have, you know, all those kind of things. Have they done their assignments? He's very hands-on. So one day, me and my father were having a discussion. I can't remember what we're talking about. And he now said that for a lot of men, that is how they show love. Okay, you're waiting for him to bring flowers and tell you you are the morning star. You are the this of my life. Without you, I can't breathe. Okay, you're waiting for him to tell you that because as a woman, that is how you express your own love. You are very caring, you're very nurturing, you're very, you know, in touch with your emotions. You're very touchy feely as a woman. So you expect that from a man. You know, when a man does that, you now believe that he loves you. That's not the truth, though. You see, let me tell you one thing about some men that are very romantic. Some, not all. Some men that are very romantic. You know how special he makes you feel. Trust me, 10 other women feel the same way. He's making them feel the same way, okay? So basically, what my father was trying to explain to me is that for a man, if you want to know if a man truly loves you, it's when he provides for his home without you even asking for some things. He's ready for it to provide. As in, you don't even need to ask too much. He's ready to provide whatever he can provide to the best of his ability. That is what true love is, okay? True love is not, I love you, talk your own. I'm telling you the fact, okay? You are free to believe whatever you want to believe. But yeah, like I keep saying, in African culture, yes, we are Nigerians, but even though with modernity and all that, many women are beginning to forget that, you know, a man actually has responsibilities of his own. Like, you don't have to do everything. It doesn't mean you're a weak woman if a man is taking care of you. That reminds me, somebody came to insult me in my DM, telling me about how, if not for YouTube, I would have been a jobless housewife waiting for my husband to give me money. And I was like, you guys saw my last video. I still consider myself a jobless housewife waiting for my husband to give me money. I'm not even ashamed of it. Okay, I'm not ashamed of it whatsoever that my husband still gives me money, still gives me pocket money till today. Yes, and after giving pocket money, upkeep, okay? Even though he gives me money for upkeep, if I still want things and I still like things or whatever, or gifts, he will still buy for me. I'm not ashamed of it one bit. I told her that. If my father calls me today and say, I don't want to be giving him money every month, I will collect. If my brother wants to give me too, I will collect and join. I didn't come to this life to come and suffer. My name is Adeze, okay? My name is Adeze, like princess. I did not come to this life to come and suffer. So I'm not one of those women who are always like, I don't need the man. No, I need the money. I need the money. As far as we're married, please bring the money, okay? Because you can't, so many things that I do, you can't do them. So please bring the money. You know, but anyway, so yeah, this struggle culture, this ride or die culture, this I'm taking care of a man culture that many black women and Nigerians are beginning to imbibe, it is only going to end in tears. No matter how you want to form that you're a strong woman, you know that you're not happy. You know you're not happy with a deadbeat husband or a deadbeat boyfriend or a broke-ass nigga. You are not happy. You know it, okay? So why are you deceiving yourself? Okay, why are you deceiving yourself? There are rich men, and some always have this talk about just because he's rich, you don't know whether he's beating her. You know, many of these rich men, they are very, you know, emotionally not there. They are very this one, they're very that one. It's a lie, my dear sister. It's a lie from the pit of hell, so that you end up with a broke man. Go and check the number of men who kill their wives. There are many of them are broke people. They are poor people. People who kill their wives, people who beat their wives anyhow. A lot of them are very poor. Okay, so whether you marry rich or marry poor, marry a good man. That's just all that matters. Okay, in fact, a lot of rich men don't even have your time. That's just the truth. They don't have your time because they are busy making that money. They don't have time to sit down with you and be quarreling for money till night. Okay, so like I said, my dear, go to where rich people are and marry for love. Go to where rich people are and marry somebody who is spiritually and, you know, mentally okay. Or are we trying to say that men who are rich are not spiritually okay? There are men who love God and who want to do right by God and who want to, you know, live a good life and make heaven and are also rich. So if you can find them, better for you, my dear sister. Okay, so this question is very interesting. Her name is Deborah Joshua, and she's asking, how do you save money as a stay-at-home mom or wife, especially if you don't have a source of income? Okay, like I said, cutting down on expenses. For me, when I wasn't, you know, when I didn't have YouTube, I've never actually been idle. I've always had something doing somehow. But yeah, the other time I wasn't making money. There are times in my life where I wasn't making any money whatsoever, and my husband used to give me a certain amount of money monthly for myself, not for the home. He used to give me money for the home, but for myself, he used to give me a certain amount of money monthly, which he still does, okay? Yes, yeah, so what I do is that that money that he gives me for myself, I try not to, because the money I'm supposed to spend on, you know, personal needs and stuff like that, I try to just buy the basics, like buy my soap, buy my cream. You know how you manage yourself in secondary school now? Buy my soap, buy my cream, buy those things that I really, really need, and then I keep the rest of the money, okay? Then even those days when he'll give me money to go and buy clothes for myself, I will just buy one or two clothes and I keep the rest of the money. So basically, as a stay-at-home mom, if you're not earning any income, you are basically going to be doing more of cutting down on everything all around, cutting down on expenses. That's the way to save money. However, if you do not have an external source of income, it is going to be difficult for you to save, you know, substantial amount of money in a short period of time. It's going to be very difficult, okay? Now, I'm saying this because as a stay-at-home mom who wasn't earning any money, the money it took me 1 year to save, when I started doing my YouTube and I started getting paid, I saved it in maybe 2 months or 3 months, okay? Do you get? So, yeah, I would advise you that if you can look for a way to make extra income, the better for you, okay? It doesn't have to be something very serious, something very difficult. It doesn't have to be, you know, millions of naira. If there's a way that you can just find extra income, extra 1K here, extra 10K here, extra 5K here, then please look for a way to do that. It will help you save more than when you're just saving only what, you know, a guy is giving you or, you know, you're getting. So the next question is from Rita. She's asking, when a married woman is buying a property, should she buy the property with her name and her husband's name, or should she buy the property with her name and her father's name as surname? Personally, I feel like you should buy it with your name and your husband's name if, you know, your husband cares about things like that. Personally, I think I'll just buy it in my name, just my name, not my father's name, as in my name as a married woman now. I'll just buy it in my name. I don't need to put my father's name there. I don't need to put my husband's name there. Like, I can just buy it in my name, you know? Yeah, that's what I feel. So the next question is from Sisi Dami, and she's asking, who should be the major provider in marriage? Your husband. Must my husband take care of all my needs? Yes, he must. Should I be open to my husband about my savings? Yes, you should, okay? The answer to all your questions is a yes. Now, must your husband take care of all your needs? I said yes, he must, because those are your needs. Now, when it comes to wants, when it comes to all those extra, he doesn't have to provide those things for you. He is not your God, okay? If you ask him and he cannot afford it, then, you know, don't kill him because of it. Go and make your wife is not paying you. Go and make your own money and buy those things for yourself, okay? But well, your basic needs, like, should your husband take care of his wife? Yes, he should, okay? Yes, he should. I'm going to teach my daughters the same thing, and I'll teach my nephews and any boy around me. He should take care of his wife financially and otherwise, okay? Yes. Adam, when God created the garden, God put Adam to take care of the garden before he now brought Eve. Okay? Okay? Like, does that make sense? He now brought Eve into the picture. Adam was already there taking care of the garden. He now brought Eve to come and enjoy. Do you share responsibilities financially? How do you cope with handling all finances in a case where the husband has lost his job? How you cope is just, it's unfortunate, but that's life. That's life. He's your husband. It's unfortunate that he's lost his job, but you just have to take up responsibilities. Like, what are you going to do? Like, are you going to now say you won't do it or what? Like, when he had a job, he was doing those things. So now that he doesn't have a job, like, why can't you do them when you can, if you can do them, okay? However, he better be looking for a new job. Like, I can't stand a jobless man. I can't. Okay? I can't stand a jobless man. Like, he better be looking for a new job. Like, you better be up and doing. Like, in the morning, you should wake up and leave the house and go and be looking for a job. Not that in the morning, you wake up, you are snoring, I'll go to work, I'll come back, you are still on the bed, you have not even had your bath, I'll not give you food, you eat. Then tomorrow morning, you tell me you're hanging out with your friends. No. If you've lost your job and you're physically fine, like, it's not something about your health or whatever. You just, maybe the company was downsizing or resizing or whatever, and you lost your job, then as I'm waking up in the morning, you better wake up and take care of the children, doing things around the house. When I leave, when children have gone to school, you better be on a laptop applying for jobs. If you're not on a laptop, you better go from company to company to go and be applying for jobs. When I come back in the evening, you know, from work, you better, you know, maybe you've prepared something for us to eat. Yeah, basically, you have to just, you know, do the wife duties in that time while I'm providing, while I'm the sole provider, okay? Yeah, you better be up and doing. Like, anytime I see you on your phone, let it be job guru. I be what? You are searching for a job. You can't just be Netflixing and chilling while I'm suffering myself all around the clock, you know, to be making money. I'm not doing anything in the house. No, you can't be Netflixing and chilling, okay? So this next one is from Ifunzi TV. Hi, and she's asking, should a husband make his wife next or kin or his kids? A husband should most definitely make his wife. Like, I don't understand. Like, your wife is the next of kin. Your husband is the next of kin. I don't know. Which one is kids? Kids from where to where? It should be the wife or it should be the husband. Then, in a case where the husband and wife is not available, then, you know, your children can be the next of kin, okay? But just because somebody is your next of kin doesn't mean that they're going to inherit everything that, you know, you leave behind or whatever. So yeah, that one's a different story altogether. Next of kin is basically most times for medical reasons, someone who can stand in for you if you are not in the right, you know, frame of mind or whatever to answer for yourself. That's basically what, or who they can notify, you know, if something happens maybe to you in the bank or to you in public or wherever it is, or if something happens to your thing and you're not available, who they can notify. That is what the next of kin is. Now, who is going to inherit, who is going to take over, who is going to possess, is basically whoever is specified in the will. So make sure you have a will, make sure your husband has a will, or make sure it is expressly stated somewhere who is going to take over, okay? So the next question is from Voice of Ruby. Hi girl, how you doing? And she's asking, she says, my boyfriend likes to save so much. I run a small business. He keeps telling me to save and save, but I believe once in a while enjoyment cannot kill somebody. Yes, yes. Or am I wrong, man? No, my dear, you're not wrong. See, me and you have the same problem, okay? Yes. Somebody replied and said that husband likes to save as well. Yes. For those of us who are our husbands like to save, please get down in the comment section and, you know, like this video, okay? Like this video if your husband likes to save. But get down in the comment section and just tell me if you are in that same boat. My husband likes to save, eh? Yes, means I like saving, you know. But I'm just like, okay, like, at some point now, we need to mess up, okay? At some point, we can't be saving all the time. Like, sometimes enjoy life too, okay? Enjoy life too. There should be a balance. But compared to my husband, I'm the one that spends money anyhow. And he likes to save and save and save and save. Left for my husband, we would have still been in one house. There's one house that we lived in before. Would have still been in that house till today, okay? You tell me, there's nothing wrong with the house. There's nothing wrong with it. And I said, I can't stand it. I can't stay in this house one more second. Like, we have to move. But left for him, he's like, let us stay because he's saving money, you know. Don't worry, one day. I'm like, which one day? Like, you know. So that pulling and pushing on both sides is actually what helps, you know, the marriage to be sweeter. It's actually what helps to strike a balance. If you go and marry someone who likes to enjoy life like you, or even worse than you, trust me, you are going to be angry because at some point, it's not be, where's money for food? There's no money for food. What about your salary? It has finished. What about my own salary? It has finished, okay? Or what happened to my income? It has finished. So, yeah, as much as it's annoying sometimes when you have a spouse who likes to save, just thank God that you have someone at least who likes to save. So many things in our home, the way our finances are structured is basically because of my husband. I keep saying it. And again, well, it's not like I don't know those things or I don't want to do those things, but because I have someone doing them, I just relax and, you know, be enjoying myself. You know, yeah. Eva, what are you doing? Say hi. She was crying, so I had to bring her into this room. Struggles of motherhood. Yeah, so for me, I'd rather a man who likes to save than a man who likes to spend, okay? Like, I can't stand men who like, cannot save money, are always spending, they're always going out, they're always dashing people money, I can't stand such men. So for me, I feel like we're the lucky ones. Yeah, sometimes it might come across as being stingy, okay? I'm not gonna lie, sometimes it might be like, okay, we're actually stingy. But if you think about it, in the long run, especially when he's, you know, he has good intentions, he loves you, he's trying to make your lives better, in the long run, it's actually better for you than your boyfriend likes to save, you know, or if you eventually get married to him. or your husband likes to see, it's actually better for you. So yes, it's still that pushing and pulling thing I'm talking about. At some point, you have to make compromises for your own sake and try, you know, to just spend money. Yes, because that's what happens in my home right now. Some things that my husband buys, some things that he brings money for, I know that 100% he will never have ever brought out that money. If not, I insisted on it, he will never bring out that money. Okay, some things that I decided that, oh, we need this thing, or we need to do this thing, or we need to go this place, or we need to go and buy this thing, or we need to enjoy this thing, you know, I know my mom will never have done those things if not for me. Okay, so yeah, at some point you're going to make him relax. It's basically you are basically going to just come to a healthy middle. Okay, you are going to make him relax a bit on his saving culture, and he's going to make you up your game on your own saving culture, which eventually in the long run is going to work perfectly for your family. Okay, so yeah, that brings me to the end of this video. You guys, this video is over 2 hours long. Yes, I've been filming for the last 2 hours. So if you don't see your question in the video, just know that I cut it out while editing it, but I tried as much as possible to answer every question that was sent to me, and I actually enjoyed answering these questions. So let me know your thoughts in the comment section. Let me know what you think. If you agree with me, let me know. If you don't agree with me, let me know. Okay, give this video a thumbs up if you like it. Please, it helps when you guys thumbs up our video. Share this video, you know, to anybody who you feel it might help, or on your community, or wherever, on your social media. Please share this video. And what else? Yeah, subscribe to my channel if you're not subscribed already. I don't know why, but you know, like, please just do that. Okay, and I'll see you all in my next video. Bye guys. Mwah.